Hello, welcome to my channel. Renzo here. Today I'm gonna paint this portrait. The colors I'm gonna use are titanium white, chrome yellow hue, cadmium yellow hue, cadmium red, permanent alizarin crimson, and ivory black. The brushes are synthetic brushes. And I'm gonna start just making this a sketch. Mixing black, red and black, a little bit of yellow, a little bit of medium. Okay, let's sketch. Let me see the position of the whole head. I can put the whole head in a rectangle like this. Okay, this is gonna be my top, bottom, around here. That means the eyes are gonna be around here. Brows, nose, and mouth. Okay, I think it's okay. Let me see a little bit of background here. All the hair here and the space for mixing colors here. I think I should move this more to my right. Well, I think I'm gonna move my canvas. Think so. Okay. Let's mix an orange, white, and black. Let me see. Stepping back. Hello, good morning, Eric, Arvind, Sanat, Kumar. Okay, checking out. I'm trying to. Okay, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to keep the light with a really warm color. And I'm going to keep all this area with a grayer, grayish, like kind of skin, but really grayish color. Let me see. I'm establishing right now what I'm planning to do. I mean, sometimes I just copy the image, but I mean not today. I just want to change a little bit the color, something to try to make it better. Yes, we always make a change because we think we're gonna make better a better painting, more expressive, more whatever you want, more colorful or mute. Let's see, I'm gonna have this warm light. Okay, this is gonna be kind of neutral between grayish skin color, and I'm gonna add more contrast to the background here. I still need to draw the face, but at least I just want to establish this first. Okay, now let's draw the face. Okay, again, let's see the center line of the face. I always do this on the photo reference, on top of the photo reference, and then I move this to my painting. And I see if that's okay. Yeah, I think the angle is just like this. Okay, now let's see the line for the eyes. See how tilted it is. Yeah, that's okay. Now, from here, just it's about to put the position one eye, the other eye, the nose around here, the mouth around here. I mean, to place the position of the mouth, the nose, and the eyes, and just following the canon. Okay. To do this, I use the Loomis method. I think that's the best method for drawing any face by memory. Okay, let me see the measurements. Here to here to here. Okay. Mixing black, red coming red, coming yellow. Okay, now this brush. This is just cadmium yellow and white. Let's see. Okay, I'm stepping back. I'm squinting down my eyes. I'm comparing what I have with the photo reference. And let's make this light, this lit area more accurate. Let's see. I'm just trying to copy the angle of the forehead, this angle and this angle, and now the same for the nose. Okay. Okay, now let's work here. Let's see some shadows here. I have this color, this has a lot of black and white, really grayish, a little bit of red, a little bit of yellow, a little bit of red. Let's see. I mean, it's not that I want just to be this kind of black and white. I have to adjust this little by little. That means I'm adding more yellow, more red, and again. Okay. Of course, this has more color. And they say that I add more yellow and more red. More yellow and more red. And then I try. Now this is too orangey. Okay. I gotta go back here. I mean, we gotta go just back and forth. That's the most important, just skipping an eye on the color of the face. That means that establish the areas on the where the face is more reddish, more warmer. And I have to see if this light is okay. I mean, because it's really warm, really strong. I mean, let me see if I keep it. If I keep this light that's pure yellow with white, or I knock down this. But I mean, I want to exaggerate this. I just don't want to copy exactly the image. But let's see. Maybe it's too much. Not so sure yet. I'm gonna add black here, just pure black. I want to create more contrast. I want to create more contrast in the background. Let me see. Okay. Hello, Arvin. Oh, that's nice. Hello, Munish. Hello, Ana Maria. Okay, let's see. I'm not using too much paint, yeah, because when we use a darker color, later it's going to be just difficult to correct. Having your 6-year-old son watching with you. Okay, that's really nice. Okay, establishing, like you see, the light, making the background darker. I'm gonna make this really warm and this kind of neutral. Neutral, I mean, it's not gonna be warm, it's not gonna be like cool, like some violet. It's just in the middle. Let's see, let's continue working here. And it's not gonna be just grayish. I need the skin color here. But definitely I'm starting this with a lot of gray. you see that looks like the background, in my background is just black and white, it's gray. Like I said, I gotta go slowly adjusting the colors. Maybe it needs a little bit more red. Do this, I add the color. If it's not working, I just change the mixture here and correct again. And remember always about the reddish areas on the face, the nose, the cheek, the upper and lower eyelid, the chin, okay? Okay, hello Nadia, hello Rob from Russia, awesome. Hello, oh thank you Nish. Thank you, Nadia. Ana Maria is asking me, is there much difference between different brands of oil paint and acrylic paint or acrylic thing? Yes, there's differences, yes. For example, usually a expensive brand, the painting is thicker and the color is more vivid. It's not like a lot, it's not something like you're gonna say, oh my god, this is so different. No, but that slight difference make a difference when you paint, yeah? When you want to create contrast, when you want to add a strong light or you want something or strong red. And more than that, I gotta say that maybe the permanence in time. I have used, I think, maybe the cheapest oil paints and another expensive one. I gotta be thorough about that. I never bought maybe one tube. I remember I got maybe the expensive one I have, it was Rembrandt, but I have seen some tubes, oil paint tubes, like $100. I never bought those colors, those brands. Well, I gotta say, when we get a commission with my friends, speaking about maybe 20 years ago, and we had to paint some landscapes, still life, like 50 paintings and like in a week, something like that. They were very cheap, okay? And if you need to, you're gonna paint something cheap, you're not gonna paint with expensive materials. And then we bought the cheapest one that we found here in Peru. We paint them, they look really normal. I mean, there was just no difference at all. I mean, for me it was just the texture. These cheap oil paints, they were kind of thin, they were kind of liquid, some colors. That means that if I wanted, let's say, red, I want some vivid red, I had to add a really thick brush stroke. And then it was everything okay, everything nice. I remember I kept one small still life for me. It was really, really small. It was some really red strawberries. Okay, and after like a 6 months, I think, I went to the painting because it was rolled here in my studio, and I just opened the painting. I was planning to just stretch the painting, stretch out in so with some stretches birds. And my surprise was that that vivid red, it was dark now. It was like a dark red. And I said, wow. I mean, you don't see that at the moment, but something happened that. Okay. And I don't know, maybe it could be the linseed oil, because we used the cheapest materials. I mean, linseed oil, turpentine, we have to, because that's the only way to make some money from that commission. Yeah. But you have an idea. No. I mean, for example, with more expensive material, I'm pretty sure that's not gonna happen. Okay, Arvin, is there a reason why you use the canvas to mix colors and not a separate palette? Yes, I love this, because when I use a palette, usually the palette moves, and I just love to keep the painting and the palette as a memory. Yeah? And I have a bunch of these paintings, all of them with the palette. And you know that, I mean, sometimes people buy me these paintings. Yes. And some people just loved to have the palette and the painting. I mean, not all people, but I mean, I remember once one guy bought me here in my country one of these paintings. And what he did, he cut the palette, he threw away the palette, and just keep the painting. Okay, I think I have established a little bit of color. Now, usually when we work on some area that's kind of grayish, doesn't have too much contrast, that is kind of difficult because we have to add more shadow and light, and there's not too much difference. And that means that I gotta go add a different value and then check out and then correct again. Okay, let's see. I see the floor reference. I see some light here. Step back. I'm squinting down my eyes. No, we have to saturate more the color, just in the transition from the highlight to the shadow, like in this case, let's say in the nose from here. So this shadow, we have to always add, it's just really subtle, okay? We have to saturate the color a little bit. This is too much, I have to just make it more subtle. Like I said, I mean, we have to adjust always, okay, a little bit. I love the contrast, I love this intense, warm light. Okay, let me think. I need to add more shadow to the background. Stepping back, I need to make this darker. Okay, let me see. Nose. I'm measuring from the brows to the nose to the chin. Okay, I think here is gonna be okay. Okay, I'm gonna just blur this, I'm gonna soft this edge because, to be honest, I'm not so sure. Okay, I'm gonna leave it there for now. Okay. Stepping back. I'm checking again and again. I'm stepping back just right now. I'm squinting down my eyes and compare with the photo reference and try trying to see the angle of the face. I think I have mistake there. Okay, I have to make some changes to some values. And let's see. Mixing basically red and cadmium yellow, that means I'm mixing an orange and adding a lot of black and white, that means that I'm graying down this, I'm knocking down this color a lot. Okay, let's see, the whole face, I was squinting down my eyes and I can see clearly that this is darker. Okay, I'm squinting down my eyes again. Okay, I think I'm gonna add more black, make this a little bit darker here, darker here. Squinting my eyes and getting close to the values. Now I think I'm gonna add more light here. Okay, that's better. Okay, let me check out again the whole head, this and this, and checking the overall shape, keeping the overall shape. Yes, I think it's okay. I'm gonna mix here more black, cadmium red, cadmium yellow hue, and let's paint a little bit of the hair. What I'm doing now is paying attention to the overall shape. Let's say that I'm checking out the drawing and the structure of the whole head and of course the face. Okay, now let's measure again the distance from the brows to the nose and the mouth. Let's see the angle of the eyes. Let's see the center line of the face. I think everything is okay. Now I'm adding always a lot of black and white because I'm trying to keep all these colors with these grayish colors here in the shadow. In order to make contrast with this yellowish area. Not more white here, okay? Like I said, I'm establishing what I want And then, of course, I have to make a judgment. Yeah? I'm not copying the photo exactly. I'm just making, trying to make something better, something that I like. Okay, Arvind, how much medium do you use while painting? I mean, usually I don't use too much medium. I think here in this painting, I have used medium just for the background. That's it. I didn't use any medium for here. I mean, the brand my paint, or my oil paint is Winton. It's not so thick. It's the student version of Winsor & Newton. Again, thinking about values, I need to make this, the brow. Yeah, I'm trying to make changes to color, harmony, contrast, but definitely I want to get the likeness. That's, I'm always trying to get that. I mean, I'm not able to get it every time, but every time I try. Yeah, I love to copy the likeness, and I love to sometimes make some changes to the color and contrast. Make more details with this brush. I can say that the tip of the nose is aligned with the iris. Another brush, small brush. I think this is going to work. think the nose is maybe too big. Let me see. Okay, here's the tip of the nose, the eye, down here, the mouth. Okay, here. Yeah, I think I have to reduce here a little bit. Oh, hello, Mervat. How are you? Okay. Okay, that's the back. I added some shadows and kind of I lighten up again. I have to make this darker again. I don't know what happened. I'm pretty sure it was darker here. See if the color is okay. Yes, I think that's okay. A little bit, I'm gonna try more yellow, more red. I think that's better. Okay, I'm gonna add some green here. I think the color is just too flat here. I'm gonna add this yellow, a little bit of black, white, let's see. Okay, I'm keeping this shadow, this more grayish, greenish. okay? And of course, I'm gonna make the ear. Pinky. Okay, I gotta think. Yeah, I think that's okay. Yeah, let's blend again. Okay, squinting down my eyes in this area here. If I squint down my eyes, I see light here, but this light is not as bright as this one. That means that I have to dark here a little bit. And here, all this have to be a little bit darker. Okay, and that's okay. No, I think it should be even darker. Okay, and adjusting the color again and adding more. I added more red and yellow to this mixture. I don't know if you see the difference. It's a little bit, I'm making this darker, but it has more colors, more reddish. again, I have to go with the eyes, make the eyes a little bit darker. And since I was blending, kind of erased the eyebrow. Put it back. Okay, I don't think I'm gonna add too much contrast here. Let me see something. Now I'm gonna add pure black here. More black. Here. I really want a really high contrast here between this yellow and this really dark. I imagined this in my head, but let's see how it looks here. Maybe it's not okay. I'm gonna use a little bit of medium to spread out this faster. It's okay. Let me check out and stepping back. Okay, I was checking out drawing proportions, the proportion of the face, the distance from the nose, the brow, the chin. I gotta check out that all the time. Let's add pure black here to the pupil. Let's see. Hello, Miri. Hello, Marcy. Mervat, love the black contrast. Yes. Mervat is telling me you need a source of light on the left top of the background because the light on her face is on the right of her face. It makes sense. Mixing alizarin crimson and black. Okay. And again. Okay, I'm going to blend again. Every time that I blend, I soft everything and I have to go again and make the values a little bit darker, or the lights again lighten. I mean, that's that usually happens when we blend. We lost contrast. We blend more, we lost more contrast. You gotta be just prepared to add again the shadows, again lights, again. Like I'm doing right now. If you overblend, even you can end up just doing this like 10 times. Okay. I think it's okay. I think I need more yellow, or maybe no in the shadow area, no on the highlights. Let's see, I'm gonna add more. I love these images with this high contrast. I love that this illusion of light, but I mean that's not easy. Let me see. I'm just adding pure white here. It's gonna get mixed with the yellow there. Moving my lights here. Mix this. I mean, it's not about just adding a lot of white, because the light is bright because of the color, because of the contrast. That's something that doesn't have color, like the background is black, and this kind of neutral, kind of cool color, and that's why it works perfectly, this yellowish light. If I make this, let's say, white without any yellow, the mood that would be different. I'm not saying that's not gonna be good, just it's gonna be different. Could be opaque, maybe could be like sad. This yellow looks really bright in the screen. I don't know why. It's not that bright here. This way. I'm going to add some orangey colors here. Mixing cameo yellow, a little bit of cameo red. More red. What time is it? 1 hour and 15 minutes. Okay, I think I gotta go a little bit faster. I'm making this stream earlier for me because I have to do some things later. Just give me a minute, I'm gonna go just a little bit faster. I gotta go out. I miscalculated the time, I think. Paint the mouth. Hello, Paul Andrew. Thank you. Hello, Marvat. Thank you, Marvat. Hello, Ardish. Okay, I'm going again and making some areas a little bit darker. Always be careful on the nose. Every time that I go to the nose, I mix more like an orangey color. Okay, because I mean, the nose is going to be always more warmer than the rest of the face, like in the cheeks and the upper and lower eyelid, but the nose especially is a little bit warmer than the rest of the face, and it's because we want the nose to pop forward. Again, I need to mix darker color and go dark here again. Making everything a little bit darker. I'm trying to control this area. You know that I'm going, like I said, adjustments is going a little bit darker, a little bit lighter. See if I can make some light here. I'm just trying something really common, really like light shadow, shadow light. There's nothing more simple than this. Okay, and I have color, I don't have color here. If I wanna create more contrast, I can add color here to make this, like right now, kind of greenish, because if you add yellow to gray, and especially a gray that is made with RV black, you're gonna get some kind of green. That works or not? It's up to you. It's about what you like, eh? Because I mean, for me, I love this color. Okay, the mouth. I need to make the mouth bigger. I need to make the eyes darker. Blend more. Okay, let's work on the mouth. Oh, one thing I was thinking of. I need to add some. Okay. To work more. I'm thinking. Paint some hairs on the face. I'm opening this package. It doesn't have any name. This is like $2 or $1.50, I think. Six brushes for $2. The brand here says Corona, but I mean, I'm pretty sure that they put any name. Need to add more paint. You can add really thick paint to the light, to the highlights. Okay, yeah, because I mean I want this to be really bright. Artich, thank you, Day Art. Ardesh, thank you, Ardesh, for your confession. Corona brushes. Yes, it's like the beer, yeah, Corona. Sadiq is saying, when I want to paint like you, I paint so bad. Yeah, Corona, like the beer, like the virus, like the beer. I thought that on the beer, no, I didn't throw the beer, the virus. Okay, don't use this. We are lethal, very dangerous. Okay, I'm gonna add more. Paint. How many colors we should have? Oh, are they just the primary colors is enough? Oh. Primary colors, I mean a couple of each one, yes? I mean lemon yellow, camion yellow, camion red, alizarin crimson, cerulean blue, ultramarine blue. That's it. Of course, black and white. And then after that you can add burnt umber, burnt sienna, raw umber. Here I'm pushing harder with my brush because I have pure black here. Any color that gets in contact with pure black just dies. Just disappears. What about another colors? Purple or green? Yeah. I mean, you can have a lot of colors. Purples, greens, blues. And I thought you were asking me about if you're about to begin to paint. I mean, you need to understand, you need to mix colors, you need to learn to mix colors. There's no purpose. You're gonna start to paint and you buy like greens, violets, because you think that I don't want to mix those colors, I just want the colors to get the colors ready to go faster. I mean, I don't think that's a good idea. It's better just to start mixing the colors, learning to mix the colors. In painting, there is no shortcuts. Well, there are techniques, which is different, but not shortcuts. It's just about practice, and just starting to paint with primary colors. We're gonna be forced to mix greens, oranges, violets, all those colors, and that's when we learn. Okay, Fire Lord, let your paintings mind look childish. Okay, this is about practice, yeah? Sadek, can I copy your video and translate into my language for my people? Oh, I think you cannot do that because it's kind of YouTube penalized that, copying the videos. Yeah? It's for the copyright rules that YouTube have to protect the content. They don't think that you're trying to just share something. It's just they think that you're trying to just to like steal something. Yeah? And at the end, I remember when I started in YouTube, obviously I didn't do any live stream, I just wanted to share something that it wasn't mine. I didn't know about the rules, and I got a notification that I was making something that is not right. Okay, let's work on the ear. Sadiq, thank you, Ana Maria. Yes, I understand, Sadiq. It's just the thing is that it goes against the YouTube rules. But maybe if, I don't know, if you want to spend the time translating to your language and you send me a translation, I can put it in this video. And then or, I don't know, but that's a lot of work. If you want to do it, that's okay for me. Okay, let's work on the email. I have to make the ear a little bit reddish than the colors around the ear, but at the same time control the value. I mean, the ear is in shadow, and that's the problem sometimes, that we want to start adding red or pink and we start changing the value. I feel that's happening to me right now. I have, I squint my eyes watching the photo reference, it's like all these areas just one value. Now, I squint my eyes watching my painting and I see the ear is lighter, and that's a mistake. That means I have to make the ear a little bit darker. And I'm gonna add more lights, use shadows. I think I made the ear a little bit darker, and squinting my eyes. No, I still see the ear lighter than the rest of the face. That means I need to make this a little bit darker. And I think I have to move the ear more to the right, I have reduced the size of the ear. Now, let's blend. I need a bigger brush. Oh, you know what? I found this image in Pinterest, but I was looking for the link today and I couldn't find it. I just found a black and white version. I don't know what happened. Okay, and because I didn't find it, I didn't put the link because I didn't find it, the colored image. But definitely, I will do it, okay? I will look for the image again. I think the space between the eye and the nose is not okay. Or maybe I have to make this eye a little bigger. Make the eye grow here. Does better. I don't see the eyelashes. I'm gonna just add some light to these eyelashes in order to see them. Yeah, because everything is kind of confused here. I don't see the iris. I don't see anything because of the hair. Now I have to mix again. I'm gonna use this orange here. looks too bright, the video. I don't know why. Oh, I think what's a mistake here. I think maybe it's the size of the forehead. I have to. Whoa. I was holding my breath. Okay. I have there is some reflected light here. And here too. Okay, I think I'm doing okay. Maybe more light here. Mm-hmm. Wait, okay, I gotta go back to the year. Okay, I need to work here. I don't know, this area is being really, really, I mean, I've been having problems here. I'm missing this light here. Maybe it was this. We're having problems with the nose and with the eye, with this eye. Now I make the eye a little bigger. I think it's better. It's getting better. Okay, I need more light here. Okay, stepping back. Oh, so that there is no link yet. Okay, I'm gonna put the link later. Hello, Adeline. Hello, Spartak. Hello, Christine. I'm comparing the painting, the image. Okay, I have to move this light more on the shadow. Sorry about the camera, is not doing okay. I know what happened. I'm thinking to go back to my old camera. I don't like this painting. Maybe, I don't know what it is. Maybe too much yellow. I mean, that's, I thought about this, about the yellow, and I like it. I like the idea. Now that I see, I think maybe it's too much. Maybe it's the color of the shadows. I'm changing my camera here because I don't see that kind of yellow, the bright, it's too bright. Okay, I need to work on the yellow. I'm gonna be thinking and painting, thinking and painting, thinking and painting. I have to move my image here, okay. Let me see. making, you know, that there is a bump here always because of all the muscles from the face go to this area. Okay, let me see, it's squinting down my eyes. Okay, I think that's okay. I'm using this brush that I've been using for blending. Just putting a little bit of paint. I'm not pressuring that much. Need a little bit of light here. Let's squint my eyes, and the reflected light on the lips should be darker. As I'm squinting down my eyes, and I see these lights so clearly, and when I squint down my eyes, I watch the, and I see the photo reference, I don't see the same. I see all this like just one value, and just I see the highlight here. That means that my values are not okay. And when the values are not okay, I mean the effect of making something pop forward or recede, it's not gonna work, okay? Because that works because of values. And now I'm darkening here a little bit. Now I'm squinting down my eyes. Better. I have to do this everywhere on the painting, every area. The whole painting, or just for sectors, if you want, it's up to you. I'm squinting down my eyes again, and I missed a shadow here. Okay, that's better. I blend. Again, I'm squinting my eyes again. Okay. The brush that I've been using for blending, just for blend a few times. Okay, this one. I'm going to move this bright. Again, squinting down my eyes again, checking out here and there. Let's see if this light here should be a little bit lighter. I'm just gonna make it a little bit lighter, okay? And stepping back, check out. I think it's okay. There's no way that you're gonna say, oh, that's perfect. There is always doubt. Okay? It doesn't matter if you have painted 100 years, it's the same always. Okay, okay, stepping back and checking out. I realize I have to move the light here on the chin a little bit down. Maybe I have to make the chin a little bigger. Let's see. I'm gonna make it and let's see if that works or not. Oh no, maybe some about the mouth. Okay, 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 okay. I have reduced a little bit the lip. No, no, I don't want to change this. I'm just keeping it just like that. I think the thing is this: the lip here is too thick. Okay, what else? I'm checking out light, shadow, of course, the likeness. We never stop checking out the likeness. And my neighbor never stopped fixing his house. That's why you hear some noises. I still have doubts about making the chin bigger. I feel that it's not a problem about the size, it's a problem about just the shadows and lights. Maybe I'm wrong. Let's make it a little bigger. Non. It's not that. As soon as I change it, I see that. No, I don't like it. It's another thing. Maybe it's the mouth. Maybe it should move the mouth up. I mean, it could be anything. It's not gonna be perfect. It's not gonna be perfect. But that's something that is not about the chin, it's, I'm pretty sure it's about the mouth. Let's see if I move just this a little bit up. Okay, I think I'm pretty sure that's the. I'm even adding. I have to reduce the highlight on the lips. Okay, that's it. I'm really happy to be able to paint every day. Yes, I think that's it. Eh? Well, you know, I can spend like a couple of hours going back and forth here. I don't think that's gonna make the painting better. And when I just don't know what to do and go back and forth, and I just start to get boring of the painting. I have to let the painting rest to go back. With the same passion that I have studied it. Okay, that's it. I'm hungry now. I gotta go. I don't wanna paint anymore. Now I wanna draw. Okay, okay, okay. Just one little thing. Hello, Monique. Hello, Dennis. Oh, Dennis is saying that it looks nice. That means really, it really looks nice. Hello, Spartak. Hello, Eve. Maybe a bit of white on the forehead. I just wanted to add yellow to make this really bright. You know what? Right now I feel like I made a mistake by adding that yellow. It feels really bright, but I don't like it. Okay, don't, I mean, it's not like that. I love my painting, okay? But in the painting, kind of I don't like that strong light. It's not what I have in mind. It's like, I don't know, it's like it doesn't work in this painting, that bright light. Yes, maybe I should add maybe more black to the background. Maybe I should add color. Because I wanted to create contrast. That's what I wanted to do. That's what I have here. I mean, if you want to create more contrast, you go with opposite in complementary colors. If I add yellow, I have to add purple, or a little dark purple. And I added yellow and black. That means one has color and the other one doesn't have color. One is lighter, the other one is darker. Okay, that's what I did. I think obviously works in terms of create contrast. In terms of color is where I think that maybe it's too bright. Okay. Now I'm thinking out loud, like always, because I used to analyze my paintings and look for mistakes, look for harmony. I change the color a little bit. I make it, you know, if I added more warmth to the light, obviously, in my intention of creating contrast, I have to make this a little bit cooler. But you know that it shouldn't be like cool. It's like a neutral color. Okay. Okay, that's it. I mean, I love to change colors, but the possibility to make mistakes when we change the image, when we add different contrast or different colors. But that's the good about painting, yes, because we have to try always. What I was trying to do, like I said at the beginning, I'm gonna try to keep the likeness as much as possible. I mean, sometimes I nailed the likeness, sometimes I don't. I'm not making an excuse, okay? I'm just trying to. Yes, maybe it's an excuse, yes, for me, for myself, because I'm gonna say something like this. Okay, you're painting this in 2 hours, 3 hours. And that's perfect for 3 hours. You didn't get the likeness this time. That's perfect. Maybe you will get it next time. And that's how I comfort myself. I hope you have enjoyed the process. And that maybe that motivates you to paint as much as possible. That's it. I'm softening edges. Maybe I should soften this edge here and just leave the nose really sharp. Okay, in this way the nose popped forward because it's really sharp. And I make this soft. And here too, soft. You remember that this thing about the edges is really important. With just the edges, you can make something pop forward and something recede. That's what I'm trying to do with the nose. Okay. That's it. the hair is kind of blurry. That's okay. Maybe just one hairs here and there. Okay, the back of the hair is not dark enough. Okay. Yeah, you put some strong light on some hair. Yeah. Total improvisation. I'm reading the Dennis comments. Is the hair pull up from the back of the head too fuzzy? Yes, yes. Okay. Okay, then it's speaking about acrylic. Okay, you can use propylene glycol. I don't know if I'm saying it right. I think that's maybe to make the dry time slower. Okay. Okay, I'm tired, I'm boring. I'm just gonna go to eat and take a soda. My kids are not here with me. My kids are spending some days with her mom. And that means that I can eat whatever I want. I think today I'm gonna eat Chinese food or maybe pizza. And I'm gonna take a beer. And maybe I'm gonna smoke a cigarette. I haven't smoked in for like a don't know. All my daughter age, I think 18 years. And every time that I'm alone, I just do something, yeah? Some beer and some cigarettes gonna be okay. Okay, I gotta go. Bye, take care. Have a nice day. Hello, Nikki. Oh, you're having vacations. Oh, you're vacationing in an amazing town. Okay, that's amazing. Okay, today I started a little bit earlier because I have to go to do some stuff. Take care, all of you. I wish you the best. Oh, Nikki, you will be able to Zoom on Wednesday. Okay. Don't worry, you know that, I mean, the recording is gonna be there. Take care, bye.